72.
That's a good shot. Emiliano Grillo trying to go low. He's trying to be the one on this final round. The 23-year-old Argentinian had designs on completing the Argentinian slam, if you will. Angel Cabrera with the U.S. Open and the Masters champ. De Vicenzo with the 1967 Open Championship. Went over 40 years between major championship victories for a native of Argentina. And all right, back to Emiliano Grillo. And a great chance here, BK, to get started with a birdie and start to get a little momentum going.
I love the discussion that you got to have right about now. How far back is too far back? And I don't think Grillo's too far back.
That was his tweet on how to pronounce his name. That was the week of the memorial when he sent that out, so.
Well, he was in contention that week and he heard his name 9 different ways. He does roll his R, so if you really want to go with it, it's Grillo. They've got a spot picked out a little left of this hole.
Oh,
he hit it.
Yes. Emiliano with a birdie at the first. Oh, nicely done. He had a horrible finish on his inward 9, which is supposed to be the scoring 9 here at Baltusrol. His round 3, he made 4 bogeys. He did birdie the 18th, but made 4 bogeys to shoot a 73. Now can he rally it back and get himself in contention? So from the first to the second, and our golf tracks gives us an aerial look at this hole, courtesy of Scott Trade.
374 yards there. Just want to lay up shy of the bunker and then approach into a hole location in the sort of back center part of the green. Opportunity for a bounce back here for Jason Day. A lot of undulation and pitch in this green in the back portion of the green.
The second hole playing is the 4th easiest in the cumulative stats this week at Baltusrol. We've had 5 eagles here at the second.
And William McGirt played with 2 of them. He played the hole 4 under par on Friday with an eagle and 2 birdies. And he was with Summer Hayes when he holed out yesterday. And McGirt made it himself, so he played it 3 under par yesterday.
That's a good tee.
Enormous figure in Jason's life for his life.
Habla Espanol, PK?
Yeah, what they're saying is they got 159 and they want to play at 158 with no spin.
And a little lower.
I heard Ocho.
Come on.
That's a good angle right here as we look down the line.
Good shot here.
Yeah.
I think Diga is light.
Yeah.
That was 150 Ocho.
Well, I'm going to enjoy tracking these two today. Emiliano Grillo. Conferences, but that time is valuable. Try to get something to eat. Try to get off your feet. Get some rest. It can be a mental grind anyway at a major championship, but especially when you're going 36 holes today.
And at the same time, you want to keep your energy level up. You don't want to get too, you know, rain and all that can have a way of just kind of getting you a little lethargic. You want to make sure that you keep that level of intensity up. It's a fine line.
Because of the pace of the third round, and just everybody played at a really good pace with the preferred lies, they actually gained 19 minutes on the final posted tee times for the fourth round, which is significant for this many players. 86 players made the cut here this week,
which is a healthy number. 70 in ties was the number.
You mentioned the accordion effect earlier, Brian. We learned at Valhalla 2 years ago just how fast these guys can go when they have to.
All right, BK, here's Grillo for birdie.
Uphill, and he's got it sneaking a little to the right.
It is.
Oh, man.
A little too much.
Wow. Yeah, those are the kind of putts. Billy Kratzer was talking earlier in the week. Breeder, you've mentioned this fact as well. Those are the ones you feel like you're putting it well, you're rolling it well, but they're not falling. So then there's that mental struggle. You got to tell yourself you're putting it well. Keep at it. They are hard to make out here at Baltusrol. That's the beauty of this golf course, and that's its protection right now.
Well, and in this situation for Emiliano, he's going to keep shooting right at the flags. He's got to make a lot of birdies. He probably has a number in his mind that he thinks he needs to get to. Maybe that number is 12 or 13. He's sitting right now at 5. He's got to go. He's got to go low.
Yeah, featured group. Jason Day, Emiliano Grillo have arrived at the signature par 3 fourth hole, the famous fourth, it's called. Breeder.
Playing 195 yards, there's a ridge that bisects this green that's just over where that golf ball landed. You can see that line showing you where the ridge is. And while that looks like a left hole location, this is really where you have to be careful. If you get this to the right of that flag, that's probably 5 paces, you get it about 15 feet to the right of the flag, and it will end up right down in that low collection area to the right.
Grillo, first to play.
6 iron.
Well, this looks good if it's the right club, BK.
It's falling down on it.
Oh, be careful.
It's gonna hang. It is gonna stay on the ridge. And the soft conditions allows it to stay on the proper shelf. He'll have a great look at birdie. A run here. By the way, best round of the day. Joost Louten fired a 65 in the final round. His play completed earlier this morning.
Soren Kjeldsen went for 65 as well. I haven't seen that 63. This is what, hey, there you go. There's Doug Steffen, the PGA head professional here at Baltusrol. He's played in a PGA championship back in 1984.
Grillo.
Actually going to work a little right toward the mountain.
Oh, oh, oh. Emiliano. His second birdie. Here he comes. He's at minus 6. He's going to have to bring the firepower. But Emiliano Grillo is off to the exact start he needed to challenge for a title here today.
You think he likes it? He loves it.
Now think about this. He Scott trade from up above on the fifth, the par 4. And this starts the stretch of very difficult par 4s here at Baltusrol.
Yeah, this hole is challenging in that you've got to negotiate those fairway bunkers. We've seen 3 woods, some drivers, and then this shot up the hill, some 7 yards uphill to a back right hole location. This is a hole that you can make some birdies, you can make some bogeys.
In the final round today, the fifth hole, he's making a run at his first major of his career.
19 birdies so far today on this hole, in the fourth round, I should say. This looks like a 3-wood.
It's definitely less than a driver.
Somebody bothered him.
Bother the shot. That's perfect. We're still very near the grandstand, near the grandstands at 4. So there's a lot of commotion from over there.
I remember that's Jimmy Walker at the fourth, the leader right behind this group today. And 277 yard of the distances on those tee shots, and they were fairway woods. Let's send it down to BK, who's down there.
Emiliano with 156 uphill and a false front, and this is going to have to be a big 9-iron.
The back flag as well.
It was big enough.
Yeah. All right, Emiliano. Right in the center of the green, still looking at it. It stopped.
He might not want to have taken on that back hole location, BK.
That did not seem like it was enough club.
Yeah.
He knows it plays
final
it.
Round.
Come in, Jason.
Emiliano Grillo taking a good long look at this one, Brian. And he is looking for his third birdie of the day. He's got quite a long putt coming, though. Golf track showed at 36 feet.
Uphill the whole way. Gets a little bit level right around that hole. That speed of the green will change as we look at what's happening around the hole.
Now all the reds are birdies today. Day inside 8 feet. Grillo with 36 to go.
Now, and Grillo's, he's just waiting for the action at 18. 18 tee is right there.
I feel like Andrew Johnston is nearby, Brian.
You are clairvoyant, Brian Anderson. Let's just let the audience know this is your first week back.
There they are.
There is no better time to start a marketing campaign than the week before a major championship in the metropolitan New York area.
Yeah, right. Good call. It's been fun.
The golf fix this past week, radio shows. Very generous.
All right, let's lock in here to Grillo. What do you have there, BK?
Uphill, going to move to the left at the end.
Really slow in here.
Gotta hit it, man.
Let's go, Gary!
There's a little ridge there that creates this back right shelf that was going to shove that right at the end. Had he gotten it there, it would have turned back left. And that ridge actually makes Jason Day's putt look very. Bow of silence for that. So that was a fairly important birdie.
You don't see monks do that very often.
No.
Well, there's a lot of things that you see in the metropolitan New York area that you don't see very often.
This is Grillo for par now.
Surprised they made it through beef at 18.
All right. If you're going to make the kind of comeback that Grillo has to make today to get himself in contention, you got to save those pars and make those testers. Stays two under on his day. Minus three for Jason Day. Let's take a look at the six from up above. Breeder, courtesy of Scott Trade.
Playing 476 yards, ranked ninth. Has surrendered just 9 birdies in this fourth round. Have to, I think, stay shy of these two bunkers and then to a green that an interesting shape. That flag located on the left-hand side, right at the base of the ridge.
All but 4 players have played this sixth hole today. And it is playing slightly under par, the toughest hole on the golf.
And this is out to the right. He liked it.
And that just got into the thick rough.
Tee shots away at the par 4-6 for our featured group. And that's where the tee shot of Jason Day lies. We'll have second shots at the par 4-6th in a moment. There's another wave coming.
They're hitting it farther.
Some great young talent that we're watching today in Grillo and Jason Day. See ball position here, courtesy of Golf Tracks. Scott Trade and Day's drive out there, 309. Grillo's at 296. And BK says here he's got 181 to the hole.
Well, surprisingly, that is exactly what I have.
I knew it would be.
And he's going to try to hammer an 8-iron out of this. And this came out low, and it is going.
It's got to stop going. Careful. All right.
Well, he's hitting fairways. He's hitting greens. He's got two birdies. Birdie putts coming here, our featured group. Emiliano Grillo, Jason Day, if you're just picking us up on PGA.com or DirecTV.
Yeah, Brian, that spot he just went up and stopped on about 4 feet short of the hole. That's actually a high spot on this green, and it looks like it'll shove the ball left. Everything else about this putt makes it look like it goes right, but right there, looks like it would go back toward the mountain. Yeah, that was that gesture right there.
Last year, Brian, at the web.com tour, he won that tour championship there last October. And then the season opening fries.com open. First player to win in his first start as an official PGA Tour member since Russell Henley did it in 2013. Just kind of threw him into gear and made him a name on the tour. Now he's contending in a major championship.
He's setting it up to start well left. Most of this putt will be influenced by the mountain. Now, will it come back left?
Good speed. Oh my goodness. Grillo thought it was in.
And I'm going to say they got that read right, Brian. From that range, if you catch an edge, they got it right.
This reaction you're seeing from Grillo has been the common reaction throughout all four rounds of this championship. These little subtle breaks on these Baltrusol greens.
Here's something else I like. He would probably have finished this anyway, but we have learned over the years you're playing with the superstar on Sunday.
Yep.
If you can finish, finish.
Great point. Great point. Dave's getting the huge roars as he's going alongside Grillo today. He thought he had it. I thought he did too. That's a tough one to take. He's putting well, very well. And now we hit the seventh. This has been the most difficult hole. It was in 05 for the PGA Championship won by Mickelson. It remains that way for this championship in 2016. This is the hole where Jordan Spieth had all of his dramatic rulings, and I'm sure you've seen the highlights and the discussions about that. Spieth played the first two rounds on this hole, 3 over par. There's been a lot of discussion about this seventh. It is PGA.com right now. You can read all about the difficulties, the challenges, why it is so tough. Very well done. Now Grillo, also with driver, and we'll trace it for you, courtesy of Scott Trade.
This is out to the right. Hard to get it all the way to the fairway on that line.
Yeah, and it just caught the lip and into the bunker, Brian. That's the difficulty of the seventh. Our featured group marching toward their second shots at seven. Dave right there, two back. Emiliano Grillo trying to climb from a past teacher of the year, PGA of America. Nobody putts and talks better than Michael Breed. putts while he's talking better.
That's going to be the latest Mark Brody stat. Putts while talking.
That is right outside our PGA.com booth. We'll hear more from Breeder in just a moment. Meanwhile, Brian Katrick is with our feature group, and Emiliano Grillo is in the fairway bunker at the par 4 7th.
He's far enough back, Brian, to where the lip is not going to be an issue. That was certainly a good break. He's got 203 out of a fairway bunker. That's not always a great break. He's okay, though. Oh, he caught it heavy. That's going to go about halfway. And that is not a great bunker to be in.
There's so much to think about with this seventh hole, Brian. There's so many different things that pop up.
He's the 10 there. He has a chance to get it to 12, and we've seen a lot of eagles on the 18th, possibly even 13.
Emiliano Grillo coming out of that bunker just in front of the green. That was his third, by the way, so he's going to be there in four.
The toughest shot in golf, the 50-yard bunker shot. Not sure why it came out left. The lie was clean.
And I also think it's a harder shot, too, when you have a back hole location. It's typically on those 50-yard shots, BK. You can get it a little bit thin. When you have a back hole location right here at the edge of the property, you know that's in the player's mind. As good as these players are. In a major championship, you can get some bad thoughts.
Well, it's already an uphill task for Grillo. He's got to be flawless today. Make a bunch of birdies to have a chance. This is the kind of moment that could take him right out of this thing.
You bet.
I like to watch football on Thursday. Jimmy Walker remains steady. Nothing.
On a par four.
Grillo's got to hold this out. Four a par.
Oh, yeah. That was a big shot.
All right, that'll be for bogey. And now these greens and the way they move and all these subtleties, or even Robert Trent Jones or Reese Jones, or is this just how this golf course has developed over the years?
You know, it's a funny thing. I mean, you design a golf course, and then over time, there's a lot of little different things that happen that lift greens up. I mean, bunkers by the side of a green over, you know, 100 years of sand flying out, that can lift the side of a green up. Mowing patterns can change the way a green can age. A lot of little different things.
Saw Grillo's trek here to this spot. He needs this for bogey. Caught it.
Pretty good five. Might have been the best shot he hit on this hole.
He is disappointed, rightly so. First bogey of the day for Emiliano Grillo. And at five under par, he'll head to the par 4 eighth. Jimmy Walker is the leader at minus 11. Stenson right behind him at 10 under. And then there's Day, along with two others. Brandon Grace, we showed you that bogey, is backed up to minus 9. And Brooks Koepka is having a terrific day. He's at minus 9 as well. From up above, we take a look. The eighth hole, the par 4, short par 4.
381 yards today. Bunkers guard both left and right. And then the front of that green, just 313 yards away. That bunker that's just shy. Saw Jordan Spieth on a Friday brought out.
He also knows because of that Tillinghast design, this green is angled to come in from the left. So if you're out to the right, you're going to want some spin. You'll get more spin out of the bunker, and this is peeling right also. It's in the other bunker.
The fun part about that is short holes at a Tillinghast golf course can still test you.
Our feature group headed for second shots at the second PGA championship at this venue. And we're watching Emiliano Grillo and Jason Day both ending up in the bunkers here, the fairway bunkers at 8.
Emiliano has 160 yards, and these guys are rooting for the ball to be in the bunker. I think you'd rather be in this one than the one that Jason's in. Hole and everything else tucked behind all these trees. I think Emiliano is far enough back to get over them and still get to the green.
Does he need to shape it at all, BK?
Well, you could cut it if you want. I think he can go right over it. He's trying to do both. It's not cutting.
All right.
Considering where he was, that's got to be close to where he was aiming it.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to send that back to research and development.
Well, you want to get the most out of your round as you can, but he knows he's got to.
Has played well, banged up before. Clearly not 100% right now.
Now beware of the weary. But Jason Day began the week talking about the fatigue, the illness that had been running through his family. He said he was a little bit under the weather as well, but he's maintained a very high level and he's got himself in position.
And this one coming across the slope here on the back of this green, working down to the right the entire way.
Not enough.
See how slow that was. He hit that hard.
Looks like once it starts to turn right, it would actually pick up speed. So obviously that one fooling him as well.
So Grillo at a par at the par 4 8th. These two headed to the par 3 9th. And they'll be able to play right away. Group ahead of them, Stenson and Keimer, have already teed off at 10. Scott Trade gives us a look from up above the par 3. Final hole going out. And today, and this four round championship playing under par.
Oh, on the left hand side of the green. That green is a pretty neat green too. It kind of moves away from the player and back to the right. That hole located on the left hand side. Very difficult to go after that location.
It's the exact spot where the pin was for the 2005 PGA.
Here it even.
Look out.
It's going to get entertaining.
It's got shootout.
Getting entertaining.
It's got shootout written all over
it. You betcha.
Stenson and Walker and Day. Koepka. Grillo now.
Also a 6-iron, and Emiliano has done a good job of boxing out, blocking out all of the commotion. It's just a little left of it.
All right, not bad compared to Day's. Not memorable either. Jason Day will have a chance at a birdie, trying to get it back to minus 10, where he started all week while we've been here, getting to this back nine on Championship Sunday.
No, I'm good, thanks.
With the fireworks just out there for someone, maybe multiples is what we've all been waiting for, and you just can feel it coming. Our feature group, Emiliano Grillo, playing alongside Jason Day. Brian Kaitrick on the ground.
About these greens. Day one was a little rough.
Just like a a champion, though.
I agree with you. I don't see that.
Let's consult the book. I don't see that either.
Grillo for birdie. Could use a moment.
Yep.
Yeah. Good call, BK.
Kept moving right the whole way.
Just stayed out. 23-year-old Emiliano Grillo is in for a par. He goes out in 33. He could have easily had four birdies on the board. He had narrow misses.
This round of golf and that nine holes turned on that tee shot and approach and putt on the fifth hole where he made birdie.
Grillo the left center and just fine.
Grillo next.
Driving in there much lower and lefter.
And longer.
That was from 172. And Grillo will have that left for a birdie. Needs something good to happen. Emiliano Grillo
was practicing. So you seldom see a good range. And the players are practicing here on an area that's part of the other golf course. But the range here is sort of an afterthought. The range at Wingfoot was an afterthought. The range at Quaker Ridge, an afterthought. In fact, there's a golf course in Scarsdale called Fenway, which is another Tillinghast. They call it the best 17 finishing holes in golf because the first hole is 298 yards, and it's just kind of an easy hole. Typically, when they were designing golf courses back then, the first hole, which was a par five, was very easy, or easy par four, as we watch Emiliano. Exactly.
Yeah, what they're saying there is that looked like it was a lot faster than that. Interesting.
Jimmy Walker making the turn with all pars through his first nine holes. He makes the turn at minus 11.
Hold still, please.
Emiliano Grillo.
Oh, thank you.
Giving this one a good long look.
Back of the green looks a little raised here, Brian. Yardage book gives no indication here. They left you on your own for the middle of the 10th green. They showed you the humps on the edges and just let you chart the rest yourself.
He did his homework to the back of the cup. Grillo, one under on the day, five under for the championship. T14 right now in the field. Brooks Koepka is up ahead a hole as the most undulating green on the golf course as well. This par 411. Grillo's got a little hybrid.
So this will be about the same line as Day's, at least the intention.
That almost looked a little fat.
Yeah, good call.
Yep, he's grinding. You can see it. He's five under. Story starting to move to the top of the leaderboard. And part of our featured group, Jason Day.
Well, their problem here is, Michael, you called it correctly. He didn't catch that cleanly. And he's got to play about a 15-yard draw here to get to this left-hand hole location. He's only got 182, but you can't go over those trees. He's got to go around them. Very nice shot.
What a shot. And getting better.
Grillo. He's got a bad look. He's got a touch angry, which is not a bad thing. And he fired right.
What a read. What a read. We've watched players all week long, BK, struggle with reading these greens. Jason Day has been phenomenal.
Yeah, that was solid. It bobbled about halfway there, but it was just straight up and down over whatever it was. Grillo's got a similar read, kind of left edge and quick. Yeah, it didn't do anything. If anything, it may have gone left. He thought the same thing.
It's amazing how just a little bit, a slight different angle, and you can get an entirely different break. I mean, it wasn't like it was, you know, separated by 15 feet. They were separated by maybe 6 feet in line. And all of a sudden, one's breaking left to right, one's breaking right to left.
Grillo, tied for 15th currently. He's at 5 under. Big story for him of this PGA Championship. Two pulls, remember on the 10th, too, he came up a little short. Went from a 6 to a 7.
Quiet, please. Quiet, guys. Thank you.
Now Grillo.
Also going to try a 5. This is a much lower ball flight. This isn't going to get there either.
Now two that come up short. Jason Day trying to make it back to back PGA championships. He is with, and it started from day one. He was in our feature group on Thursday. Felt like he had the speed immediately. The first putt he hit on the first hole he played. Grillo's got 69 feet remaining, Brian.
Couldn't have had a better teach than he just got out of Jason. Line and speed. Now you just gotta do it.
Right in here is where it starts to move back to the right.
Great.
He got the teach and he learned.
Great lag. Yeah, he's all smiles walking up to that one. Has made this par easy on himself. And a pat on the back from Jason Day. Says you're welcome.
Yes.
Take that 3 and run.
Yep.
Keep him in the top 15 for now. Now Scott Trade gives us a look from up above here. This 13th hole, this is one of the great holes in golf. This was the hole that Bobby Jones patterned his 13th at Augusta National after, this 13th at Baltusrol.
Opposite direction in its movement, but same concept. Bunkers guarding the outside edge of the dogleg to the right with a hazard on the inside edge. It's really just a question of how much of that are you going to cut off?
Comfort Jason Day when it's burning hot like it is to see Cole with that smile.
Yeah.
Put you in a good place. More than just a caddy to Jason Day. Emiliano Grillo now. We'll trace this one. Scott Trade brings us golf tracks. And he's got, looks like he's got driver in hand. He does.
So driver on the line that he's going to hit it. He's probably going to take this right off the edge of that bunker there. Possibly even fade it. That is exactly what he did.
Yeah, that soft landing, the fairways. This 13 took on the most water of any of the holes here at Baltusrol, and still in very little rollout. From Don, Jay Day, Jimmy Walker putting on a good show. Final nine holes at Baltusrol. I agree.
Three of the easiest holes on the golf course are still in front of him. Holes 15, 17, and 18.
Grillo's got this left. This is for birdie. Great approach. That'll break him from the pack a little bit. There's a big group at minus six. That's going to put him in that group. Grillo with his first birdie on his inward nine. They head to the par four, 14th. Scott Trey gives us a look from up above.
This hole, 14th hole, is the 11th most challenging hole on the course today, and got to find the fairway. It's the angle that you take to this hole location, which is on the right hand side and in the back. This is a hole I think Jason Day is going to have to take advantage of.
And now Grillo and Day at the tee at 14. Grillo coming off the birdie.
Driver. Heavy wind into him. Got to keep it right. This is a good one.
He's got that driver dialed in now.
Yeah.
Just outside of 300 on.
All right, BK Grillo now.
109, 24. One tree, tree.
137 for Grillo. Way out to the right.
Oh, he's found the bunker.
Not his best.
Nope.
Now coming off the birdie at 13. Grillo's got it to minus six. Daniel Summerhays, we mentioned, it's been so steady all day. Walker is a hole behind Jason Day, so he's been able to keep close tabs on him. Stenson a hole ahead at 15. And Grillo surveying this bunker shot, which will be his third on the par four.
It's a good lie. You're looking at that. A lot of things you can do with this. These are the ones that BK, these are the makeable ones.
Exactly what I was going to tell you. Just enough on the down, on the upslope, and back up toward the mountain. Why not? He hasn't made one of these all day. There are so many areas of the game that they are better than us, and this is one of them. They make these look routine.
Now wide open that club face is. Is it going to release enough? No. But still better than the average.
Yeah, it was almost too good. Yeah. I don't think he thought he could get that out of there that softly, and potentially forgot that he was going up into the mountain. That was too good of a bunker shot.
Well, it had that sound, right?
Yeah.
You know when you hit it pure out of the bunker. Grillo to save a par. Second shot into the bunker right. Blasted to here, so this for four.
Well, the caddy read that doesn't have to hit it would tell you inside right and firm. If you have to sign for a score at the end of the round, you might hit it a ball out on the right. Be a little more careful.
Nice.
All right, that'll keep him in that group at minus six. That includes Jordan Spieth, Webb Simpson, who shot 70 in the final round. Padraig Harrington with a 68. He went 65-68 in the final two rounds, the former PGA champion. All right, Michael, it's the final par four in regulation for these guys today.
And the 16th most challenging hole, which is French for the third easiest hole. Just avoid that. Those bunkers really don't come into play. Just find the fairway. That hazard 367 yards off the tee, and you can see averaging under par, 3.85. Very accessible hole location. Seeing that back left, that's anytime you're Jason Day and you get a left hole location, you kind of like it. And you notice, by the way, how many back hole locations we've seen here today. Typically what the field staff will try to do is mix it up with some rights and some lefts and some centers.
He is bogey free today with back-to-back birdies at 10 and 11 and 13. So day two down, Grillo. After the par, we'll have the tee here. He is going back to the driver. He's had two really good drives in the last two holes with that club. I think this group, they're just waiting. Let some of the commotion clear behind them.
Remember, this tee is in play off the 17th hole. So the folks over at 17 are kind of right behind him.
We saw Ernie Els drive onto 17T when we had him in our featured pairing. He backed out of that.
Yeah, way out to the right.
He's been a little bothered here.
Now somebody barked out his name, Grillo, just as he was walking into the shot. He didn't like that. He backed up, he started over, and it still got him irritated.
That's the worst shot that we've seen him hit after he's backed out. Backed out a couple times, and they've both been pretty good.
That has all the feelings of an aggressive play because you're running out of holes.
Emiliano Grillo will be first to play. The poorest tee shots we've seen from him today.
Is he going to have to mess with that tree, BK?
Not to the hole location today, which is over on the left. That's a good break for him. He's got 149, and it's not a good lie. His turn by more than 10 yards, but neither one of these guys looked ready there. Jason Day has the entire broadcast crew and Marshall and crew faked out right now.
Just caught part of that tree.
He did not have to go over there. That ball must have jumped a little right on him. It's going to probably come off the front of the green.
He's got some scoring holes in front of him, as does Jason Day, but so does Jimmy Walker.
Jimmy Walker putting at the green at 14. Jason Day at the 15th. He's got a long birdie attempt coming. He and Grillo coming up short. Grillo with 83 plus feet remaining on this one.
And he's got to come over that ridge. And unfortunately for him, it's not uphill all the way. So you can't just go have this one barreling up to the hole. About three quarters of the way through this putt, it stops. And it's pretty flat from there. Moving to the right the entire way. Check that. Moving to the left the entire way. I'm facing the wrong direction.
Oh, for those of you that have not done on-course commentary, that is such a true statement. got to move.
Yeah, he's going to come up well short. Starting to crumble just a touch here for Grillo. Agitated on the tee. Struggled through his round three today. Shot a 73. Was three over. With four bogeys on his second nine. Did have a birdie at 18 in round three. But that essentially took him out. Fast start today. Birdies at 1 and 4. Gave one back at 7. He had a birdie at 13 to get him to minus 6. No chance to win, but still a chance to cash in and keep moving up the board as best he can.
That putt didn't help Day one bit. That was like Grillo had a partner back. But he didn't really stare. He was being polite. Grillo can help this time. Outside the hole, considerably moving left.
And Day will be an interested onlooker. Oh, we've got a worm cam going here, BK. Started about a cup outside and not enough.
Moves a lot.
Yep.
What a great look at that putt.
He's going to have to give it at least a cup, and that had some speed to it, too. I mean, he hit it hard. And there's frustration.
Yep. Yep. 23-year-old Argentinian had designs on becoming the third native of Argentina to win a major championship.
Experience is what you get when you don't get what you want, and he's getting some experience today.
Has driven one into the tree line behind him. So now, three holes remaining in this PGA Championship. Par fours are in the books. Par three, 16th, is next.
The third most challenging hole today, 215 yards. Sorry, the fourth ranked hole. Dang. A number that'll probably be 5 or 6 iron shots. And if you're Jason Day here, and you post 13, do you go 13 as a winning score right now? BK?
Well, I don't know that he can do any better than that, so yeah, I think you think 13 is the winning score.
Are you thinking score right now?
Maybe on this walk. But you know what's in front of you. I don't think he needs to know until he gets to the 18th fairway.
Yeah.
Also a 5 iron.
That looks good.
Much better line indeed.
Tracking right at it. All right, Grillo's on. All eyes on Jason Day, Jimmy Walker, our featured group coming in at the par 3 16th. Jason Day trying to do it in 15 and 16. Tiger Woods accomplished the feat 99 and 2000, then again 06 and 07. Prior to Tiger, Denny Shute in the late 30s was the last to go back-to-back at the PGA Championship. Watching Emiliano Grillo playing with Jason Day. He's got a putt here at the 16th for birdie.
Really odd light right now. Big dark cloud hanging over the holes we're on. Light clouds around the fringe there. Strange. Mood lighting.
Yeah, there's a little pop-up that just kind of has gone to the south and east of us.
Golf Tracks has both players 48 feet from the hole, and Grillo will play first. I took a bounce.
And never moved left.
Yeah, it wasn't going to go left.
Look at how confused he looks. He cannot believe that.
I can tell you, Jimmy Walker did make his par at 15. So So he stays at 13 under. Hey, Jimmy Walker. Emiliano Grillo has this left to clean it up.
And you wonder if Jimmy Walker, standing on the tee, seeing all this, has had a chance to reflect on a two-shot lead with three holes to play, or if he's able to keep his mind focused on the task at hand, which is this shot on this extremely challenging par 3 16th hole.
All right, Grillo's got it. That's a three for Emiliano. That'll keep him at minus five. Our feature group heads to 17. And this is where the action really picks up. Back-to-back par fives, a true three-shotter here at the 17th.
And Jason Day struggled with his tee shot on this hole yesterday. Hooked it up against the left of the cart path there, then played a cut to the right, back into play. But this, with the tee boxes forward, must find the fairway. And if you go driver here, you might have a chance, depending on what the wind is, and we'll find that out from BK when we get down there, might have a chance to get this onto the green. It is up a box, but it is also soft out there.
Two easiest holes on the golf course, 17.
Yesterday, or I guess on Friday.
Grillo quickly with driver. Yeah, it's a good one.
Likes it. A good shot.
Okay. Jason Day and Emiliano Grillo make the walk. Second shot's coming at the par 5 17th day, down two at the PGA Championship. Looking back at Jimmy Walker on the last hole. Well, this is where these tee shots ended up. Both drivers. Grillo in the fairway at 292. Still 323 left. This massive par 5.
The wind has started to push to the left. That's a complete, that's not a complete change, but it's a 90 degree, 45 degree change. I don't know, it was hurting, now it's going left. You figure it out.
Good shot there by Grillo. Now Grillo.
86 yards. This is plenty. This is going to spin a lot. And it did.
These back-to-back par fives, they can create so much drama. Well, we have it here today. Look at this massive par 5 17th that measures 649 yards. They are ranked 17 and 18, the two easiest holes on the golf course, and all kind of drama available. And it's shown up so many times in major championship history at Baltusrol. You think about Jack Nicklaus at the 18th. There's a plaque down on the ground.
They hit a 6-iron off the tee anyway. So I don't think Jason Day needs to know what the score is until he gets to the landing area. You hear the crowd reacting here when someone puts a camera down in front of folks that have been sitting here all day. And obviously, like most everything else, the crowd's here a little bit more vocal than they are in other parts of the country.
Grillo first.
This putt should move a little to his left, BK.
That's correct. Won't be all that quick.
I like to watch, by the way, on a putt like this, I like to watch if the ball doesn't go in the hole, how it settles. Tell you what's going to happen around that hole. That is in.
Oh, how about Emiliano Grillo? Such valuable experience here for Grillo at 23 years of age to put himself in this kind of position in a major. Had a bad third round. I won't deny that. Bad finish to that third round. But he's been in the All right, Breeder, the 18th here.
This is the easiest stretch. The easiest hole on the golf course. Three eagles that has given up today. And the scoring average is 4.35. First, you've got to find the fairway right there. And then back up the hill to this hole location, which is a very similar hole location as we saw on Thursday's round. This is a putt right in here. This is going to be where they're going to be aiming. This putt right here is not going to move that much. If you are in line with that hole, there's not a lot of break. He's going to have to go eagle hunting. We have seen, by the way, 49 birdies and only one bogey and one double. How about that? One bogey and one double. We just had our fourth eagle.
Fairway wood for Grillo. Got the tee at 18. Bad right.
That is right to right.
Look out in there. So right, he cleared that line of spectators. I think they hardly noticed.
That's closer to the fifth hole.
This is likely a three wood, I would think. I'm a little surprised he got that to the left of that hole location.
We're back to our feature group now. Emiliano Grillo and Jason Day. Grillo missing way right. Brian Katrick following this group.
Well, he got lucky. He just barely got outside the gallery ropes. He's got 299, so not going to reach. But he's got the tree. Those tree branches there overhanging. They're going to bother him in his backswing, I think. Top of his swing, he may be messing around with some branches, and that is incredibly disconcerting.
Well, if he could break free from the pack here at minus six, could get inside the top 10.
Yeah, 7-under right now is tied 10th.
Ahí tenés 155, 60 bolas, ¿está?
So this iron is going to try to go all the way across the water, knowing that he can't reach. He's going to try to get to the next lily pad here. Bueno.
Martin Keimer, who made the lone bogey on the 18th hole, was one of the four people that made the eagle. Remember, we watched him make that bogey on 18 when he was coming in. In the end of the third round, just made an E.
Did not hear the roar either.
Yeah, it was swallowed up by his own roar after knocking it on in two. Grillo.
Right at 100 yards.
His third. Okay. Check out the guy up the ladder here. Watch this. Watch and listen. And now he knows.
It's official.
They have now posted the 14 for Jimmy Walker, and Jason Day wants to see the tee shot. He knows that's his only hope.
What a shot he hit. That does not in any way reduce the level of that shot that he hit from 257 out to
I'm sorry, guys, he is staring back to see where Jimmy Walker is walking.
Jimmy is just about to reach the fairway now, so he's got a little weight to go. He is walking right down the center of this fairway.
These are the putts that actually sneak away from the mountain here. Might be right edge for Emiliano.
An important putt for him.
This is for a top 10 finish at the PGA Championship.
Not a great result with that putt, but I think he will be proud of his performance in this 98th.